Packing blood sample, outside laboratory. Items for blood sample. Laboratory form. Selection of syringes, from left to right, 2 mL, 5 mL, and 10 mL. Blood tubes, left to right, yellow, oxalate fluoride, 1 mL, pink, EDTA, 1 mL, orange, heparin, 2 mL, green, heparin, 2 mL, red, plain, 2 mL, and red, plain, 7 mL. The oxalate fluoride, EDTA, and heparin tubes all contain an anticoagulant, which prevents the blood from clotting, and each have an active ingredient to retain certain parts of the makeup of the blood for certain blood tests. The two plain tubes have no anticoagulant, thus the blood clots. Needles, left to right. Blue, 23 gauge, 5/8 of an inch. Green, 21 gauge, 5/8 of an inch. Yellow, 20 gauge, 1 inch. Blue, used for cats. Green, used for small to medium dogs. And yellow, for large to giant breeds. Biohazard bag. To place the lab form and blood sample. There are two separate compartments within the bag, one for the lab form and one for the blood sample. This is for health and safety reasons, in that if the sample leaked during transit, the lab form would still be legible and not contaminated. Writing on blood tube with patient details. Date, patient ID number and name. Writing on the lab form with the patient details, including the date and what blood test is required. Writing on a jiffy bag with lab address. Then placing lab form into biohazard bag. Preparing equipment for packing the blood sample. Child lock pot and cotton wool. Blood sample is wrapped in cotton wool before being placed into the pot. This will absorb any leakage during transit. Mixing of blood sample. This is carried out if using an anticoagulant sample to ensure the contents are fully mixed to prevent the sample clotting. Rotating the blood sample backwards and forwards and rolling between the palms of the hands. Note, do not shake to mix. Hemolysis will occur and the sample will be destroyed. Wrapping blood sample in cotton wool, then into the child lock pot, then into the biohazard bag, then into the jiffy bag, and sealed. Best to send samples in first class mail to ensure the lab receives the sample as soon as possible.